900 diverse seniors
who have come together
for one simple purpose.
Graduation.
A representation of past failures
and successful deeds
is found in each and every one of us.
Find out what happens
when seniors stop pretending
and start being real.
We are one mind.
We are one body
and one soul.
We are the last class of the millennium.
We are the real seniors.
Real seniors.
The real seniors.
Real seniors.
Another turning point, a fork stuck in the road.
Time grabs you by the wrist, directs you where to go. So make the best of this test and don't ask why. It's not a question but a lesson learned in time. It's something unpredictable, but in the end is right. I hope you had the time of your life. So take the photographs in still frames in your mind, hanging on a shelf in good health and good time. Tattoos and memories and dead skin on trial. For what it's worth, it was worth all the while. It's something unpredictable, but in the end is right. I hope you had the time of your life. Something unpredictable, but in the end that's right. I hope you had the time of your life. It's something unpredictable, but in the end that's right. I hope you had the time of your life.
Sarah.
Crazy hair day.
I ain't got much to lose, 'cause I've seen better days. I'm in a star omitted place. I've seen better days.
And the bottom drops out.
I've seen better days. I'm in a
star. I had some so good. These days get so long, and I got nothing to do. I've been hanging around this town corner. I've been bumming around this old town so long. I've been hanging around this town corner. I've been bumming around this old town for way too long. We spent all day getting sober, just hiding. Watching TV, we just look a lot better in the blue light. You know I gotta get out.
Yeah.
Yes, I'm J-Bo, and I'll be going to homecoming. This is my last homecoming. I plan to get it crunk for all the boys.
She's got the lily white cavity quasars. She's got could give. You saved me, of this I'm positive. It took a little while till I could see there could be no one else for me.
Homework detentions and these beauties are things that we are probably not going to miss from our days here in DP.
But here are a few things that did make the cut.
Of this senior year in this high school, I'd have to say, is the bathrooms. I really enjoyed the bathrooms being totally clean all the time. I mean, they're
clean.
They were nice and clean all the time. Every single time I went to the John, I'd have to say there was no pee on the floor or anything like that. I really enjoyed Dr. Phillips High School bathrooms.
I think I miss most about being here is being with my friends, doing the news with my good co-anchor, Jeff Butera. We rock doing that. I'm going to miss doing band as much as it kills me to say. I had a lot of fun doing it.
Let me think about this carefully. Is it going to be the boys? No, it's not the boys. Definitely not the boys. The schoolwork. No, it's not the schoolwork either. I'd have to say it's...
Administration. No, I can't say that. No.
You know what we're going to miss about high school? Absolutely nothing!
The one thing that I miss about high school is going to be all the parties and the football games.
The thing I'm going to miss the most after high school are the really comfortable desks that make it really easy to sleep on. Because, you know, this class was just boring. So you had to sleep or do something fun.
What I want to miss most about high school is I want to miss, what's that? I'm going to miss playing basketball because my career is over. I'm not going anywhere.
The only thing that I'm going to miss about high school is actually your friends and having a big time, like the prom and that stuff.
I think the most thing I'll miss is the sports.
Yeah.
And all the girls you can get.
What I'm going to miss most about high school is the long lunch lines that you have to wait for to get your lunch every day. That's what I think I'm going to miss the most.
I'm going to miss walking into that cafeteria, taking a warm smell of that great food, and then vomiting all over the trash can.
And I'm going to miss nothing, nada, que expresión.
Interesting. You know what I'm going to miss? Not having a date for Valentine's, not even one single year in all my 4 years of high school.
Yeah, I think I'm going to miss going into the bathroom and doing what I need to do and realizing there's no toilet paper.
And, you know, you don't have any holes on the bottom, so you can't really ask your neighbor for a little charity, if you know what I mean.
True.
See ya. In 10 years from now, remember us. Bye.
Bye.
I will remember you. Will you remember me? Don't let your life pass you by. Weep not for the memories.
Seniors, we have spent the last 12 years in school. Each year, just waiting for summer vacation to come to relieve us of everything that has anything to do with school.
Clearly I first saw you smiling in the sun.
This year it's different. We're moving on.
I will remember.
After summer, we will not be returning to Dr. Phillips.
Will you remember?
This is it. It's almost over.
Don't let your life pass you by. Weep not for.
What will you remember after you're gone?
I'm so tired.
I'll remember the faces of the people I passed in the hall. I'll remember my best friends who were always there for me, no matter what I said. I'll remember the last dance at homecoming.
Funny how it feels.
I'll remember the laughter coming from the back corner of my fifth period class. I'll remember the people who've left a mark on my life that will never go away.
I will remember checking my mailbox for college acceptance letters.
Will you?
I will remember signing your book.
I will remember the excitement of the last football game.
Pass you by.
I will remember our final show on WDOC.
I will remember taking the senior class picture, knowing that the last time we'd all be in the same room together would be at graduation. I will remember getting up at 5 a.m. to get ready for Toga Day.
I will remember saying goodbye. I will remember graduation, but I'll never forget prom.
So afraid to love you, more afraid to lose. Clinging to a past that doesn't let me choose. Where once there was a darkness, a deep and endless night. Gave me everything.
Years, 720 days, 5,040 hours, a little over 302,000 minutes, just shy of 20 million seconds. A lot of time for memories. But we asked the graduating senior class for just one. 2 minutes of their responses follow.
I think my favorite memory was, you know, coming here every day, having fun with all, you know, my friends and stuff like that, especially when we got to dress up as nerds and stuff like that.
Memory was when we did Oompa Loompas.
My favorite memory is when that guy right there kicked the jail and Coach Dwight, and the jail went flying all the way across the gymnasium. And I'm about to do an impression of Theo McWhite. yeah, this is Coach McWhite. I like to say peace to all my people.
Miss the football games and all the Pantherette practices and all the friends I made through that.
My favorite day had to be y'all. I think it was a pep rally day, and I ran up on the field.
I would have to say my best moment of my senior year was running at state for cross country.
Our favorite memory was going on the senior trip to England,
France, and Holland
with CIS.
I guess my favorite memory would have to be all my friends sticking there for me, like Jeff, Mark, Lonzie, Jermaine. That's my best memory of my senior year.
Okay, our favorite memory is our friends.
My favorite memory from high school would be skipping class and not getting caught.
Forming Othello my freshman year.
My favorite memory of my senior year is senior picnic day when we had a lot of fun out there climbing the wall and stuff and playing that football Velcro thing.
Favorite memory is when we almost won the state championship my junior year, but then we didn't because we lost in baseball. We could have, but we didn't because we lost.
Senior day with the same green. I got every single girl you can think of.
Right. My favorite memory being a senior and all the years I was here is making fun of everybody that I don't like, which is pretty much everybody in this school. Just kidding. Peace out.
All I ever wanted, love and the peace and the harmony, just to be, to live and shine. When I get ready, I up and fly. And I can't remember none of the things that I want to forget. It's the best satisfaction, no less. Ask if I'm free and I say, oh yeah.
hidden reality. Everybody knows there ain't no such thing, and it's clear. It's obviously this is not the place I'm supposed to be. On and on and on I've searched. What I'm looking for is not here on earth. I can't stand.
Named Captain Morgan, and I'm gonna sail the high seas of Capst. We're all getting out of here. It's finally over. We've done our 4 years.
Are we getting married?
No.
No, but we're going to leave, though, but I guess we'll see you guys around.
We'll be back.
You know, we're sitting up in that big corporate office with that nice suit.
Oh, I love my young boy.
Sure, Ricky.
Bye, Mark.
Yeah! The end coming soon.
Pick up my cap and gown. Hope it's there. It's probably not because I've got... Well, it's here.
It's by Dr. Phillips. It's been cool.
At graduation, be thinking about everything that's happened in the past 4 years.
I think I'm really going to miss my friends.
I'm going to cry my eyes out on my graduation day.
We've been best friends for 4 years.
Best friends since first grade.
It's just yesterday, I feel like, you know, I was a freshman.
If I didn't have my friends, I don't know what I would do.
And so we talked all night about the rest of our lives. Where we're going to be when we turn 25. I keep thinking times will never change. Keep on thinking things will always be the same. But when we leave this year, we won't be coming back. No more hanging out because we're all on a different track. And if you got something that you need to say, you better say it right now because you don't have another day. Because we're moving on. Can't slow down. These memories are playing like a film without sound. And I keep thinking of that night in June. I didn't know much of love, but it came too soon. And it was me and you, and then we got real blue. Stay at home, talking on the telephone. And we would get so excited and we'd get so scared. Laughing at ourselves, thinking life's not fair. And this is how it feels.
Sometimes I am scared about the future.
I don't know how to say it, but
I am scared about the future.
So if we get the big jobs and we make the big money, when we look back now, will our jokes still be funny? Will we still remember everything we learned in school? Still be trying to break every single rule? Will little brainy Bobby be the stockbroker man? Can he ever find a job that won't interfere with the tan? I keep thinking that it's not goodbye. Keep on thinking it's our time to fly. And this is how it feels. As we go on, we remember all the times we had together. And as our lives change from whatever, we will still be
still.
y'all.
Bye, DP. I'll miss you a little bit.
Bye, DP. We're gonna miss you next year. Don't miss us too much.
Bye, DP. We'll miss you.
Say bye to all my teachers.
Look, what's that look like?
I'd like to say peace out. I'm glad I'm never gonna be here again.
No,
I had a fun time.
Sorry for picking on all you guys, and have some fun and good luck in life, and I hope to see you at the reunion, and don't go to jail. Bad. Bye.
I just want to say bye to TP, and I hope everybody has a great graduation and is successful in their future.
Bye, DP. We'll miss you. We love you all. We'll miss you.
Every now and then we find a special friend who never lets us down, who understands it all, reaches out each time we fall. You're the best friend that I find. Can't stay, part of you will never ever go away. Your heart will stay. I'll make a wish for you, and hope it will come true, that life will just be kind to such a gentle. Oh my, if you lose your way, think back on yesterday. Remember me this way. Ooh, remember me this way.
Not the hair. I love my hair.
Alright,
Wally, we'll be like,
bye.
Strudel.
Strudel. Pie.
Ice cream!
What?
Ice cream!
I'll be your friend.
I'll be your friend.
And now and we can split and half and like roll our separate, you know.
Okay, let's go! Okay, yeah. We gotta do this like quick like a bunny.
Quick like a bunny. Fast like Well, I hope you guys all enjoyed watching our video as much as we enjoyed making it. Thanks for all the memories, and hope to see you guys in 10 years. Bye!
Promise me that you'll give faith the fighting chance, and when you get the choice to sit it out or dance, I hope you dance. Taking chances, but they're worth taking. Loving might be a mistake, but it's worth making. Don't let some helping heart leave you bitter. When you come close to selling out, reconsider. Give the heavens above more than just a passing. When you get the choice to sit it out or dance, I hope you do.
Believe me, being in the classroom today would be a heck of a lot.
Bravo!
great pleasure to announce our top 10 class of 2000, starting with Jeffrey Butera. Jacqueline Dolan. In Her. Jeannie Kahn. Brittany Marling. Adam Melanson. Angela Richmond. Carolyn Wendler. Tanya Williams. Rounding out our top 10, class of 2000, Matthew Yang. I present to you our top 10, class of 2000, at Dr. Phillips High School. On to some very special awards. The National Council of Teachers of English recognizes top English students across the country. We are pleased to have three of these top students. The National Council of Teachers of English Achievement Awards go to Danielle Adams, Sarah Julian, and Sarah Pryor. Achievement finalists. These students ranked among the top half of the top 1% of African American students across the nation. The recipients of this award are Danielle Adams, Rashayla Marie Brown, and Tanya Williams. Thank you. Our National Merit finalists rank among the top half of the top 1% of all high school students across the nation. The recipients of this award are Jacqueline Dolan, Sarah Julian, Daniel Moraseski, Tanya Williams, Matthew Yang, thank you guys. And Tanya, you'll need to stay up here because we have an additional certificate for you. You are one of the few finalists to be the recipient of a National Merit $2,000 scholarship. The certificate reads, the National Merit Scholarship is awarded to Tanya J. Williams in recognition of academic promise and distinguished performance in the competition of 2000. Congratulations, Tanya. And congratulations to all the National Merit finalists. Thank you, guys. It is that point during the ceremony that we present to you the salutatorian and valedictorians of the class of 2000. These students have excelled in all of their academic studies and have earned the distinction of the top senior students. And once again, I'm glad I don't have to pick them. It's a tough job. Our salutatorian is Carolyn Wendler. And again, this year we are pleased to present 12 valedictorians. These are the best of the best. To be named valedictorian is a great honor, particularly so when the graduating class is comprised of over 700 students. In alphabetical order, the valedictorians are, and I'll read the college after them. Danielle Adams, MIT or Harvard. These are our year 2000 valedictorians of Dr. Phillips High School. This truly is a very, very special year. Thank you all very much.
Within the reach of everyone who takes the time to be kind. For making others happy, we will be happy too. For the happiness you give away returns to shine on you. If you can imagine it, you can achieve it. If you can dream it, you can become it. Always believe in yourself and know that you can do and be whatever you wish to be.
Ryan, is it okay if I come here to this mic? Can you give me sound over here? Hello, hello, hello. There we go. I don't usually do well behind a pulpit. How y'all doing? You know, I recognize some of you from the Palm Lake Elementary School days. You've changed quite a bit. So have I. I lost my hair, but you've got better looking over the course of those years. I'm glad to be here with you tonight. Now, I know there's only one song that you've been thinking about as you come to the end of your career here. All these wonderful years at Dr. Phillips High, graduation coming up on Thursday, there's only one song that you're thinking about. Now, I'd like the seniors to stand up. Stand up now.
It's called a mortar board. And again, the only time you're going to wear this thing
is when you're doing some graduating. Now, I know you'd rather not wear this. I have some things that you might want to wear instead. All of you style dogs would really prefer to wear an Abercrombie & Fitch cap, and then you'd feel like you look really cool. And then, others of you who are the beach types, you're going to want to wear this look. Some of you who think you're so hot shot because you got this degree and you're so very smart are going to be wearing these. Sorcerer look, which is so very academic, is it also looks like the dunce cap. So if you see anybody wear one of these, that tells you something about where they're headed. Now, because you are the millennial class, if any of you have the good fortune to go over to Epcot during the celebration, you could be wearing one of these. And this would be my choice if I were going to wear it, but I'm not. I guess the best thing to wear for you all would be your good old CC cap. And any of these would work well. Any one of these, even that goofy sorcerer's hat, would probably be better than this thing, right?
Okay, well, when I was asked to give the benediction, I thought that this would be the perfect opportunity to give some closing words of wisdom. I live by the philosophy that everything happens for a reason, and God has a special plan for every single one of us. When I was talking about this with a family from my church, they said I should tell the story of Joseph. As a young man in his teens, Joseph was taken away from his family. He was out on his own, and in many cases, he could do whatever he wanted. This sounds a lot like our situation as we go off to college. Joseph remained a good man, however, and always did what was right. People could see this quality in him, but it seemed as though things never went his way. His brothers wanted to kill him. He was sold into slavery and thrown into prison. When Joseph interpreted one of the Pharaoh's dreams that there would be 7 years abundance of food and 7 years of famine, the Pharaoh put him in charge of food distribution and made him his second-hand man. When the famine came, Joseph's family came for food and were surprised to find their brother in such a high position. Joseph said to them in Genesis 50, verse 20, "As for you, you meant evil against me, but God meant it for good in order to bring about this present result. To preserve many people alive. If Joseph hadn't have gone through everything he did, he would not have been put in that position, and all the Israelites would have died. This is to show you that all things happen for a reason, and when things get tough, don't give up hope. God will lead you. As we move on with our lives, we may come across some mountains that may seem hard to climb. But remember what it says in Romans 8:28. As we know that God causes all things to work together for good to those who love God, to those who are called according to his purpose. I wish you all the best of luck next year and congratulations. And please stand for the benediction." "And let us not lose heart in doing good, for in due time we shall reap if we do not grow weary. So then, while we have opportunity, let us do good to all, and especially those who are of the household of faith. And my God shall supply all your needs according to his riches in glory in Christ Jesus. Now to our God and Father be the glory forever and ever.
Thank you. recorded than messing up.
I'm going to go to the hospital.
and moving up around the real time to get into the office. My last name is Cooper, Lieutenant Carl Cooper.
Girls,